Welcome to the future. Planet Earth is home to many spectacular museums, from the Louvres in Paris and Abu Dhabi to the Guggenheims in New York and Bilbao. They each have their own personality, their own voice, and their own purpose. So when Dubai set out to create the first museum in history that would look to the future instead of the past, it's no surprise that it resulted in one of the most complex architectural structures ever made. This is the Museum of the Future. They said it couldn't be built, an architectural enigma defying physics, logic, and even gravity. But in the heart of Dubai, a stainless steel torus now stands as a living monument to the future. Architect Sean Killer envisioned a structure that symbolizes humanity's boundless potential. A torus-shaped design with its void center that represents the unknown. A canvas for future possibilities. Conceived by the Dubai Future Foundation, the Museum of the Future isn't just a repository of artifacts, it's a dynamic incubator for ideas, a platform where science, technology, and imagination converge. So what was the architectural concept or design philosophy behind the Museum of the Future?
To create a building that is using the highest technology of the building construction industry, whether it's throughout the ages of doing the pyramids or the Pantheon in Rome or, you know, several other buildings throughout the ages, has always been the sort of limits of the technology at that time. So it's really about using a parametric, regenerative optimization and creating a building shape that really encapsulated the future as that vessel that moves in visionary from Sheikh Mohammed's father to himself to his future generations.
Standing 77 meters tall, the museum's elliptical form posed unprecedented engineering challenges. Traditional columns were eschewed in favor of a steel diagrid framework comprising 2,400 intersecting beams, meticulously designed using parametric modeling and using BIM technologies. The facade features 1,024 unique stainless steel panels, a nod to the 1,024 bytes in a kilobyte. Each panel was robotically fabricated and installed by a team of skilled workers and AI-guided arms. It took over 18 months just to assemble the facade. And then there's the Arabic calligraphy, laser cut into the shell and designed to function as windows. The script was based on quotes from Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid Al Maktoum, the ruler of Dubai, about the future, learning, and progress. With Arabic calligraphy by artist Matar bin Lahej. These inscriptions are not merely decorative. They function as a supplementary source of lighting, allowing natural light to permeate the interior. By day, the light floods into the interior. By night, the building glows from within. Inside, you won't find historical artifacts. Instead, it's more like stepping into an interactive sci-fi movie. Visitors are launched on an immersive journey through space stations, biolabs, climate-controlled ecosystems, and AI-driven experiences. Beyond its aesthetic allure, the Museum of the Future is a paragon of sustainability. Achieving LEED Platinum certification, the building incorporates passive solar design, grey water recycling, and is powered in part by a dedicated solar farm, supplying 30% of its energy needs. The verdant mound upon which it sits not only elevates the structure, but also symbolizes Earth's resilience, integrating nature into the urban fabric. The museum offers an immersive journey through time and space. Exhibits span from space exploration and climate change to health and wellness, each designed to provoke thought and inspire innovation. Visitors engage with interactive installations, AI-driven experiences, and visionary concepts that challenge perceptions and ignite curiosity. Like the Guggenheim in Bilbao, the Museum of the Future in Dubai defied almost every convention in architecture and engineering. Most museums have walls. Some have facades. But this building, it has a continuous, flowing, doubly curved surface, one that twists in three dimensions, wraps the entire structure, and carries load. And that created a problem that no one had solved before. How do you skin a building that has no flat surfaces and no repetition anywhere? Every panel had to be custom made, not just hundreds, but over 1,000 unique stainless steel and glass reinforced composite panels. Each panel had to curve in two directions. Each had to align exactly with the building's steel diagrid. And each had to be strong enough to handle Dubai's brutal heat, with temperature swings of up to 45 degrees Celsius in a single day. Then came the real issue: installation. With no straight lines to use as reference, traditional surveying was useless, so the team turned to point cloud scanning by Leica Geosystems and AI-assisted modeling. With augmented reality headsets, workers could see digital overlays of the final panel positions right inside their visors. It wasn't just high tech, it was necessary, because one misaligned panel could throw off the whole building. In the end, even the installation sequence had to be algorithmically generated. The skin was hung from the top down, like zipping up a 3D jigsaw puzzle, where every piece only fit in one place. This wasn't construction. It was digital choreography on a scale architecture had never attempted. And the result? A facade that is seamless, heat-resistant, and visually iconic, but only because the engineering was decades ahead of its time. For all its futuristic engineering and cutting-edge technology, this building is still unmistakably Dubai, because one of the core tenets of this city is hospitality. And the Museum of the Future doesn't forget that. It's not just a building to admire. It's a place for people, families, children, the curious, and the creative. Down on the lower levels is Future Heroes, a bold, immersive play area designed just for kids. There are no screens here. Instead, it's all about collaboration, exploration, and hands-on missions. The museum was also designed to be directly linked to the city's metro system, allowing people to arrive by public transit and step straight into the future. Or they can arrive from the adjacent Jumeirah Emirates Towers Hotel, one of Dubai's most famous early skyscrapers, now physically and conceptually connected to the museum. Inside, the comforts continue. There's the Salt Restaurant, an Emirati-owned brand that's become a national success story. And one of the more unusual experiences you'll find is the Algorithmic Perfumery, a lab where artificial intelligence helps visitors create a scent uniquely tailored to them. But the most iconic part for many visitors is the museum's viewing deck, where you step inside the inner void of that massive torus, a 360-degree ring of sky and steel, and look out over the city that built it. Because it's not just about what the future will look like, it's about how it should feel. But the Museum of the Future is also doing something very old. It's telling a story about power, about progress, about vision. Because here, architecture isn't just about buildings. It's about identity, a willingness to push towards the future. Legendary architects like Dame Zaha Hadid, Adrian Smith, Santiago Calatrava, and Lord Norman Foster have already contributed to the Emirates' skyline. And this museum, by Sean Killer, is designed to shape how Dubai is perceived around the world. It isn't buried in a cultural district or tucked into a quiet campus. It's right there, at the front of the stage. That's what this really is: a message, not just to locals or tourists, but to governments, tech companies, startups, and investors. Dubai wants to be seen not as a place reacting to global change, but leading it. And that message is working. And this is one of its most powerful messages yet. It's a structure that will turn heads for generations, with exhibits that will evolve with human understanding. It stands as a modern-day majlis for the curious, for scientists, and for its futurists.
The key is to understand the future. And I think that's what the Museum of the Future is all about. The future is there to be created by people who have the initiative and the daring to seize the opportunity.
As we look to the future, we invite more entities to join us in this endeavor. We can continue to position Dubai as a global launchpad for innovation.